Would you rather fight 50 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck? What kind of fucking question is that, William? Seriously, like, who wants to fight a horse or a duck or any of those things? I don't want to fight anybody. I'm a lover, man, you know?
I had a bit of a think about that, William, and you know what? I'm a lover, not a fighter.
I'm gonna go with the one horse-sized duck. I'm no multitasker, and I prefer one monster at a time. So, there you go. I might want to love 50 duck-sized horses, though, because that'd be fun, like, if you had 50 tiny little horses. Dude, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Hey, Laz, can we get some duck-sized horses? I want a bunch of little ones.
You know, 50 duck-sized horses, 50 of them running around, crazy. I don't know. I think I could probably handle the one horse-sized duck better. Ducks can be violent. So, I don't know, probably the one horse-sized duck.
Well, William, the martial artist in me would like the challenge of 50 horses. But I think I'll take the duck, big duck, because I think I could take it down pretty fast and then just get back to Netflix or whatever. You know, it's like it's sort of one move. But if you think about it, you know, I think lots of little ducks or lots of little horses, tiny horses the size of ducks, that's a lot, that's 50 of them, that's a lot, right? It's a lot of fucking horses with four legs that run really fast. That's like piranha, I'm thinking, like, you know, like you fall into the river and the piranha just come. So even though they're tiny like ducks, horses are powerful, right? So you kind of condense that and they're just smacking the shit out of you. I think that'd be painful. So I think I'd rather take the horse-sized duck. It's got the wings, it's got the beak. You could get out of the way of it. It'd probably move slower than you would imagine. Although, you know, okay, so my buddy Landon is helping me with this interview, and he just gestured to me, like a shotgun gesture, bringing up the obvious point that I probably could have just shot the duck, even being horse-sized. Can I have a gun, William? Can I have a gun? I'm not really a violence gun kind of guy, but if, you know, that would sort of end it. And the 50 horses would be, yeah, you know, fuck you.
If I had to, the one horse-sized duck.
I would welcome a fight of 50 duck-sized horses. Sounds like a great challenge. I'm willing to accept.
Lynn Rector Crystal asks, what is your favorite tattoo, if you have any, and what does it mean? I only have one tattoo at the moment, Lynn, but I'm planning my second as we speak, which I'm really excited about. But it is a sea turtle symbol that I have on my right foot, and it's a really important tattoo to me, and I love it. It represents my connection with my husband because we've always spent a lot of time together in the ocean, especially scuba diving, which has been one of our great hobbies for years. And the sea turtle to me is probably my favorite creature in the ocean. And also it represents long life, longevity. So my sea turtle is really important to me. I'm planning another tattoo as we speak.
What is my favorite tattoo? I don't have one. I don't. Sorry. The truth of the matter is I've had tattoos for so long, I don't even remember I have them half the time. But I do have a little tribute to Morris there. It says Mo, and there's a little hat there. And I do really like that one. Believe me and Spencer both got those tattoos right after Morris passed away, as a tribute to him.
Well, actually, it's this right here. Is that showing up okay?
Yeah.
Okay, it's Mo. It was for Morris. Me and my cousin Steve got him. Like within days of his passing, it's the fedora hat he used to wear and his nickname Mo underneath, and that's still my favorite. A lot of them have sentimental value, but that's just, is what it is.
I do not have an ounce of ink on my body. I'm afraid of needles, I'm afraid of any of that stuff. So I know everybody in my family, well, most of them have tattoos. I can't really tell you what anything means because I don't have one on me.
I think my favorite would be Papa on the back of my neck. I got that after my dad passed away. That's what I called him.
I only have one tattoo. I personally never see it myself. It's on my upper back. I'm not about to show you now.